Everybody must have got a very good result. Yes. 10th result, everybody has checked. Some of you are getting 100 marks also. Very good. Yes, very good. Good, good, good. Very good. Very good. Many, that's 100 school first, sir. Many have got 100. Yes. Many have got 99, 97. Very good, bachcho. Very good. Excellent. How much a height and distance is in trigonometry, but that is a very small part that we'll do afterwards. Hai na? That's a very, very, very small part of trigonometry. Only you have to use tan formula, but not for this week's test. See, this week's test is till the part which we have done till tomorrow. Hai na? So all the parts which we have done till tomorrow will be coming in your test. And hai na? Okay, so don't think that height and distance will come and all. Don't worry. Okay. Yes, very good. Everybody is getting very good marks. See, 10th marks are important, but they are not that important. You know, your 12th and 12th will be more important. 11th and 12th are the most important school, means classes. As if I'll consider JE, you know, okay. Very good. Very good. Okay. It's okay, bachche. Don't worry. So let's start today's class. So we have done some questions. We have done some questions. So let's continue with there. That only we'll start solving some questions based on the part which we have done till now. Okay. So let's see if I can find some good questions. Okay. Just wait for a second. Okay, write down the question. Very good. Okay, write down the question. So question is, find the value of sine 24 degrees, sine 24 degrees, cos 6 degree minus sine 6 degree, sine 66 degree divided by sine 21 degree, cos 39 degree minus cos of 51 degree and sine of 69 degree. Okay, calculate it. Sine 24, cos 6, sine 6, sine 66, sine 21, cos 39, cos 51 and sine 69. Anyone? Yes, minus one. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Yes. So let's start. Yes, minus one is correct answer. This is equals to minus one. Let's see. So they have given sine 24. By they have given sine 24 and cos 6. If I look at the right side, cos 6 and sine 6, I understand. But this is not means this is not making a perfect coordination, right? So 66 I can also write as 90 minus 24 is nothing but 66, right? So 96 minus 24 is nothing but 66. So I can write this as sine of 90 minus 24 degree. This is nothing but cos of 24 degree. So this can change. This can be changed to cos of 24 degree, right? Also, this is 21, 39, right? This is 21, 39. This 69 can be written as 90 minus 21, and this 51 can be written as 90 minus 39, same as the previous one, and the same as the numerator. So this whole thing will get converted into sine of 24 into into cos of 6 minus sine of 6 into cos of 24 divided by sine of 21 into cos of 39 minus cos of 21 into sine of 39. So this will become sine of 24 minus 6, and in denominator you will get sine of 21 minus 39. So this is sine of 18 divided by minus of sine of 18. So this whole thing gets cancelled and this is minus 1. Okay, copy this. Very simple question. Copy this. If you have done this, then write this. Sine square 5 degree plus sine square 10 degree plus sine square 15 degree and so on till sine square 90 degree. This part is bacha, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. So this is sin a minus b, sin of a minus b. Sin a minus b is 21 minus, this is a, this is b, 21 minus 39, 21 minus 39. So this 19 by 2, correct. So this is 21 minus 39. So this is minus 18. Sin of minus 18 is will get cancelled out. So this will come minus 1. Okay. Now let's move on to this question. Solve this one. Very simple question. We have actually done this before. Yes, 9.5. Very good. So see, sine square 5, sine square 10, sine square 15. This middle point will be sine square 45 degree. And on the left side and on the right side, you will have some terms. On the left side and right side, you will have some terms. So you will have 5, 10, 15, 20. Then you have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. 35, 40. So how many terms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 terms on the left, 8 terms on the right. Now see, 8 terms on the right and then you have sine of 90. So you can write plus sine square of 85 plus sine square of 90. Hai na? Right? Right? So you have sine 45, then afterwards left and right side, you will have 8 terms on the left, 8 terms on the right, and then you have sine square of 90. Right? So see, sine square of 5 degree and sine square of 85 degree. Sine square 85 degree can also be written as cos square of 5 degree. So these both well combined will become 1. So sine square 5 plus sine square 85 will become 1. Then you have sine square 10 plus sine square 80 will also become 1 and so on till 45. Sine square 45. So this will be 8. These all terms will be 8. Then this is 1. This is sine square 90 is 1 plus sine square of 45 is 1 by 2. So this is 9 plus 1 by 2, which is nothing but 18. Sorry, which is nothing but 18 by 2 or 9 1 by 2. Hai na? Just copy this. This week's test is not difficult. It's simple. Very simple paper I have given. All the questions in the class which we have discussed, something like that only I have given in the paper. Okay. So discuss, solve the question in the class. Solve the question in the class. Oh, sorry. Sorry, not 18 by 2. 19 by 2. 19 by 2. Solve the question in the class. Solve all the question in the class. Solve all the question which we have done in the class. Solve all the question which I have given as a homework. Hai na? Only from those question I will ask the question. I will give the paper. Okay. I hope this one is okay. No, no, it is not easier than last week. Same level. Same level I will give. Okay. Now, next question. Write down. So cot of फाइंड द वैल्यू. साइन सीरीज में बच्चा यू कैन साइन सीरीज व्हाट नॉट इन स्क्वायर. साइन सीरीज वाज नॉट इन स्क्वायर है ना. नो नो नेक्स्ट वीक ओके. सॉल्व दिस वन फर्स्ट. सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन. सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन बच्चे. साइन स्क्वायर ऑफ साइन स्क्वायर ऑफ 45 इज 1 बाय रूट 2 होल स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज 1 बाय 2 है ना. दैट इज व्हाई वी विल गेट ओके. यस आंसर इज नॉट 1. आंसर इज नॉट 1. 1 इज नॉट करेक्ट. 1 इज नॉट करेक्ट. दैट इज व्हाट दिस इज एन इजी क्वेश्चन. दिस इज एन इजी क्वेश्चन बट दैट इज व्हाट आई मेंट टू से दैट व्हाई एम आई गिविंग यू इजी टेस्ट. फर्स्ट यू बीम बस फर्स्ट यू मास्टर दीज ट्रिक्स देन यू मूव ऑन टू अ हार्डर और डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन है ना. फर्स्ट यू मास्टर दी स्मॉल स्मॉल ट्रिक्स हाउ यू विल गेट द करेक्ट आंसर. वन इज नॉट करेक्ट. वन इज नॉट करेक्ट. चेक इट वंस अगेन. वन इज नॉट करेक्ट. नो विदुषण प्लस माइनस वन इज ऑल्सो नॉट करेक्ट. द आंसर इज माइनस वन. द आंसर इज माइनस वन. चेक हाउ यू विल गेट आंसर इज माइनस वन. Yes, second quadrant. Yes, very good, Ashwin. Yes, very good, very good, very good. Second quadrant. See, this is sec theta. This is sec square theta minus 1. This is nothing but 10 square theta, right? This is nothing but 10 square theta, right? But this is cot of 111 degree into this is under the root of 10 of square theta. This is under the root of 10 square theta. Under the root of square of something, if you have under the root of x square, this will be x in mod. This will become x in mod. If you remember, root of something can never be negative. Root of something can never be negative. Right? So suppose if I will write root of x, so root of x square, hai na? This will become x. If you write simply root of x is equals to x and x is equals to minus 2. If x is equals to minus 2, so this will become what? This will become what? This will become minus 2. Right? And on the right side and on the left side, this is what? Under the root of minus 2 whole square. So this will become under the root of 4. So this is nothing but 2. So right side and left side are not, they are not matching. So that means this is not correct. This is wrong. So that means what mistake we did? Writing under root of x square, we should have to write is equals to mod of x. Understood? This under root of x square, this will become under mod of x. So when you are writing tan of theta, so this will become cot of 111 degree into tan of theta will be mod of tan of theta. This will be mod of tan of theta, right? And this is cot of 111 degree is 1 by tan of 111 degree. And this is mod of tan of 111 degree. Because this is negative, 111 is in second quadrant. 111 degree is in second quadrant. Second quadrant. So that means this will be negative. So that means this is minus of tan of 111 degree divided by tan of 111 degree. So this will get cancelled and you will get minus 1. Understood? When x is less than 0, when x is less than 0, we have already solved. This will become minus x. And when x is greater than equal to 0, this will become x. Okay? So tan of 111 degree is negative. So that is my minus 1. Minus 1 and minus 1 will get cancelled and you will get minus 1. Not 1. Not equals to 1. Yahi pe you will make mistake. Hai na? So just copy this one also. Then we'll move on to the next question. अरे बच्चों 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 ओहो अरे बच्चों दिस इज सपोज टेन टेन ऑफ 111 डिग्री इज माइनस ऑफ 3. सपोज द आंसर इज माइनस ऑफ टेन ऑफ 113 डिग्री इज माइनस ऑफ 3 राइट. सो दिस विल आई विल राइट मॉड ऑफ टेन ऑफ 111 डिग्री इज नथिंग बट मॉड ऑफ माइनस 3. I can write this as minus of minus 3, which I can write this as minus of tan of 111 degree, right? So this will make it is equals to 3, right? But here there is no mod. So that is why this mod will open as a minus of tan 111 degree, and this denominator is tan of 111 degree. So this and this get cancels, answer will be minus 1. Understood? Le lo bhaiya, dekh lo. Check previous page also. अरे नहीं कौशिक बच्चे, आई एम सेइंग अज्यूम 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 बच्चे अज्यूम अज्यूम लेट्स अज्यूम दैट इट इज माइनस थ्री. ओहो इट इज नॉट इक्वल्स टू माइनस थ्री. आई एम सेइंग लेट्स अज्यूम लेट्स टेक अ नेगेटिव वैल्यू सम नेगेटिव वैल्यू सम माइनस ऑफ एक्स. अंडरस्टूड? फाइन जस्ट कॉपी दिस वन. आई एम सेइंग दिस अज्यूम इज इट टू बी यू कैन टेक इट माइनस ऑफ के where k is greater than 0. You take minus of k where k is greater than 0. Hai na? So I'm just assuming it. It is not equals to minus 3. Okay, just copy this one. Okay, next is find the value of if x is greater than 0, then mod of x will be greater than 0. Yes. बच्चे tan of 111 डिग्री इज इन विच क्वाड्रेंट. 111 इज इन विच क्वाड्रेंट? सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट. इन सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट tan इज नेगेटिव. फर्स्ट थिंग विच आई टोल्ड यू वाज दिस थिंग ओनली अवस्थी. यस है ना अश्वती. यस अश्वती दैट वाज 111 इज इन सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट. सो सेकंड क्वाड्रेंट tan विल बी नेगेटिव. आई होप वी हैव कॉपीड इट. नाउ लेट्स डू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Let's write the next question. Sine of 120 degree into cos of 150 degree plus cos of 240 degree sine of 330 degree is equals to. Find the value of this. Sine of 120, cos 150 plus cos 240, sine 330. Sine is positive in second quadrant, but tan is negative. Hai na? Tan and cos are negative. Okay, just copy, solve this one fast. Very simple question, bachche. Solve this one. माइनस ऑफ 1/2 नॉट 3/2 माइनस ऑफ 1/2. सॉल्व इट केयरफुली. दिस इज इजी क्वेश्चन. जस्ट डोंट मेक मिस्टेक. ओके कॉस साइन ऑफ 120 कॉस ऑफ 150 कॉस ऑफ 240. ओके okay, let's see. Sine of 120 solution. Well, let's see if we are getting what value we are getting. Sine of 120 is what? Sine of 90 plus 30. Cos of 150 is what? Cos of 90 plus 60. Cos of 240 is what? Cos of 180 plus 60 and sine of 330 is what? Sine of 360 minus 30, right? Sine of 90, sine of 90 plus 30 is nothing but cos of 30. Sine of 90 plus 30 is cos of 30 into cos of 90 plus 60 is minus of sine of 60, right? Plus cos of 180 plus 60 minus of cos of 60 into sine of 360 minus 60 is sine of minus of sine of 30 degree, right? This we are getting. Cos of 30 is minus of cos of 30 is what? Root 3 by 2. Sine of 60 is what? Root 3 by 2. Right? Sine of 60 is root 3 by 2. Cos of 30 is root 3 by 2. Plus minus cos of 60 is what? 1 by 2. Sine of 60 is what? 1 by 2. Right? So this will be what? Minus of 3 plus 1 by, sorry, sorry, this will be plus, sorry, minus and minus plus. So minus of 3 minus 1 by 4. So this is minus of 2 by 4. This is minus of 1 by 2. How is this 0? How is this 0? How is this minus 2? How is this minus 3 by 2? I do not understand. Simple, same simple calculation. बच्चे रेफरेंस एंगल वॉज टू स्टार्ट फर्स्ट रेफरेंस एंगल फॉर अस टू स्टार्ट द फाइंडिंग वैल्यूज है ना. रेफरेंस एंगल वर फॉर अस टू स्टार्ट फाइंडिंग. नाउ वी नो, सॉरी दिस इज प्लस वन, प्लस वन. रेफरेंस एंगल फॉर वॉज अस टू स्टार्ट फाइंडिंग. नाउ वी नो डिफरेंट मेथड्स. वी नो दिस इज अ सिंपलर मेथड. दिस इज ऑल्सो वी आर इनडायरेक्टली फाइंडिंग यूजिंग द रेफरेंस एंगल ओनली, बट दिस इज अ सिंपलर मेथड एंड दिस वी हैव डन ऑलरेडी मेनी टाइम्स. So there should be no confusion. There should be no confusion in this. This is a very simple question, bacho. Okay, fine. Okay, next question. This is a little bit lengthy. So find the value of sine of 18 degree. Find the value of sine of 18 degree. Then find the value of sine of 36 degree. Find the value of sine of 18 degree. Then find the value of sine of 36. Fast. Huh. 180 is 180 minus 530. Yeah, that is also correct. You will get the same answer. You will get the same answer. Kaushik, you will get the same answer. Find the value of sine 18 degree and sine 16 degree fast. Find the value of sine 18 degree and sine 16 degree fast. I have asked question from this. I have asked in the question from this in the exam. Okay. If you are doing trigonometry, you should remember these values. If you are doing trigonometry, you should remember these values. However, for JE perspective, it is not important. However, for JE perspective, it is not important. But school board, for your board perspective, it is important. For your perspective of your board exam, it will be. It is important. Okay. So let's see. So I will solve it once. Huh. So sine 18 value. Remember this thing, sine 18 value is nothing but root 5 minus 1 by 4 and cos 18. If you remember, cos 18 value you can find using sine 18. Yes, sine 36 value is what? Sine 36 value is cos 36 I will write. Cos of 36 value will be simply root 5 plus 1 by 4. So sine 18 we can find, and this is cos 36. If you have cos 36, we can find sine 36 also. And we have this thing we can find. Okay. And how to find sine 18? If you remember, we have already done this. How to find sine 18 value? Sine 18, we 18 degree. How can we write sine 18? Sound sine height 18. How can we find sine 18? 18, if you remember, 18 into 5. 18 into 5 is 90. So we can write 5 into 8. 18 into 5 is 90. So we can write 18 degree as A. So this will be 5A is equals to 90. Right? So 5A we can divide and write as 3A and plus 2A is equals to 90. And then what we did, we took 2A on the other side. So this is 2A. Is equals to, oh sorry, we took 2a on the other side, so this is 3a 3a is equals to 90 minus 2a. And then what we did, we took sine on both sides. So sine of 3a is equals to sine of 90 minus 2a, right? And then we can find, okay? Then we can find, okay? Just copy this method. And then write another question, a different kind of question, okay? Just copy this. Copy these. Okay, fine. I hope everybody knows this, right? Everybody knows the value. Very good. Okay, so now write down the question. This is the next kind of a method in finding the range of the following function. So suppose you have a sine theta plus b, or a sine x plus b cos x. If you have something like a sine x plus b cos x, how can we find the range of this? How can we find the range of this, where a and b belongs to real numbers, where a and b belongs to real numbers? So see, listen very carefully. This is an important concept. So what we can do, see here, a and b, I can divide this whole thing with under root of a square plus b square. See, one before this, first thing is, see, if I have to find the range of this, what I can do, if I have these trigonometric ratios in two forms. So we have got sine of something and cos. We have two trigonometric ratios in the same. What I will try to do, I will try to combine these two and I will write it in only one form, only in one trigonometric ratio, right? So how can I write in only one trigonometric ratio? We have already seen sine of theta plus x, or theta minus x, is equals to sine of theta cos of x plus minus cos of theta sine of x. Or if we can write cos of theta minus plus x is equals to cos of theta cos of x plus minus sine theta sine of x. Hai na? If I will compare these two parts, that means this equation, hai na? And this equation. Sorry, and this equation, this part, right? Or even this part, hai na? So let's see. So what we have got is, what we can see is that, see, here we have sine of x. Here we have sine of x, and here also we have sine of x, hai na? Here we have cos of x. Here also we have cos of x. Just wait one second. I will write so that you won't get confused. Yes. This is x plus minus theta, x minus plus theta. So this can be written as sine x cos of theta plus minus sine theta cos x. This is cos x cos theta minus plus minus sine x and sine of theta. Now see, if I'm comparing these two parts, this one and this one, hai na, with the equation, right? So what I can see is that here I have one sine x, here also I have sine x. I'm writing here cos x, here also I have cos x. So that means I can convert this into the sine of x plus theta. But how will I get this theta? So what we can do is, in this equation, a sine x plus b cos x, right? If I will divide this whole equation by under root of a square plus b square, and here also under root of a square plus b square, hai na? If now I will take this a under root of a square plus b square and this b under root of b square plus b square. So let's see. So if I will take a by under the root of a square plus b square, right? By, see, this is always less than one. Less than or equals to one, but this is always less than or equals to one, because this is denominator is always greater than a, right? So that means this part we have seen. Okay, so now what we can do is, if this is less than 1, that means this can be treated as this, and this is always greater than equals to minus 1 also. So this can be treated as, suppose if I will treat this as a cos theta, suppose if I will treat this as a cos theta, because this is theta we do not know, any arbitrary theta, value of theta we do not know. So if I'm treating this as a cos theta, then I can write a triangle, I can form a triangle, which is, this is theta, and cos theta is a upon under the root of a square plus b square, right? So what will be the sine theta? Sine theta from this triangle will become b by under root of a square plus b square. That means if this thing I have taken is equals to sine theta, sine of theta, then this thing will automate, oh sorry, this thing if I've taken as cos theta, this thing if I've taken as cos theta, then this thing will automatically become sine of theta, right? So what will this whole thing transform into? Cos theta, and this is sine theta, this thing will transform into cos theta into sine theta plus cos theta into sine x plus cos x into sine theta, and this thing can be written as sine of x plus theta. This thing can be written as sine of x plus theta. Now see, if I have divided this with root a square plus b square, then I have to multiply also with root a square plus b square. So that means this thing is multiplied with root of a square plus b square. This is a positive value, root of something is positive. Sine of x plus theta is less than 1 and greater than minus 1. So root of a square plus b square, if I multiply sine theta plus x, this will whole be less than equals to under the root of a square plus b square, greater than minus of under the root of a square plus b square. Understood? Copy this one. So this means the range of this function will simply be under root of a square plus b square and greater than minus of under root of a square plus b square. So this is the final answer. Okay, copy this one. I will solve this question once again. I will give you an example and then we'll solve a question. Okay, copy this one. I will give you an example and we'll solve it once again. Copy this whole, this method of finding the range. Then I will give you an example also. Are sir, please make me host. What they are writing, I'm not able to understand. I'm not able to see. Please make me host. Yeah, but a shaded part is not a formula, but this is a result. I mean, you can see this thing is the result of whatever we are. This is, you can say it is a formula, but this is a result what we are getting. Hai na? Bachche, I'm trying to solve this using a certain method, you know. So what I did is I divided this with a square plus b square so that I can compute this with a cos theta. I can equate this equals to cos theta so that I will be able to form the triangle. If I'm equating this as a cos theta, this will become a sine theta for me, so that I can form this part. cos theta sin x and cos x sin theta. So this will get converted into sin of x plus theta. Okay, so this will be equal. Okay, I hope everybody has copied. So let's see. One question I will give. You will be able to understand. First, you do this question. Find the range of sine of x plus cos of x. I will solve this right away. And from this, you will be able to understand. See, this is again sine x plus cos x, right? Sine x plus cos x.
I want to combine
and form only in one trigonometric ratio, right? Either it can be sine x or cos x. Either it can be in sine or cos, anything, hai na? So what I will do, this is multiplied with one, this is also multiplied with one. See, if I will divide this whole thing, from here I got the idea. If I multiply and divide this with root 2, that means root 2 is
the
root of 1 square plus 1 square. So
this Amit, Amit sir, it's audible to you? Okay, unmute panna.
Yeah, what a, please.
Amit sir. Hello. Amit sir, it's audible to you? Amit sir. Students, it's audible to you? Hello.
Okay, so this will become sin x by root 2, right? Sin x by root 2 and cos x by root 2, right? So what this will become, this will become equals to 1 by root 2 into sin x plus 1 by root 2 into cos x, right? So this is 1 by root 2 into sin x plus 1 by root 2 into cos x, right? Yes, tell me.
Yeah. One second, sir. I will give some instruction to the students. Just give me 5 minutes. Not five okay. minutes, 2 minutes. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
But yeah, I'm not able to see your messages, please. He has removed me from host. I don't know why.
No issue.
So this is sine x by root. So try to understand. Sine x by root 2, sine x by root 2 and cos x by 2, I'll take sep.
Dear students, உங்களுடைய கிளாஸஸோட வீடியோஸ் எல்லாமே லானிட்டி எஜுகேஷன் அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு யூடியூப் சேனல்ல வந்துட்டு இருக்கு. ஸோ நீங்க என்ன பண்றீங்கன்னா, லானிட்டி எஜுகேஷன் நீங்க போயிட்டு யூடியூப்ல போய் டைப் பண்ணீங்கன்னா உங்களோட வீடியோஸ் எல்லாமே அதுல இருக்கும். ஸோ நீங்க போயிட்டு அதுல சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணிக்கலாம். தேங்க்யூ சோ மச் சந்துரு. சார் கொடுத்துரு.
Yes, sir. Ramesh sir, you just actually I'm not using the speaker, so I'm not able to hear you. If you have any information, you can just write to me. Okay sir. Ramesh sir, okay, fine. So see, what we have got here is actually I do not have speaker, so I'm not able to hear, but it's okay. Ramesh sir, is it over now? Okay, fine. Chalo. Okay. Sine. Okay, so see, we have sine of x divided by root 2, sine of x divided by root 2 and cos of x divided by root 2, right? So now see, this root 2, if I'm dividing, so I have to multiply this also with root 2. I have to multiply this with root 2. Now one thing which is to be noted is, see, if this thing I will write by 1 by root 2, I can write cos of theta, cos of 45 also. And sine of 45 also. This also I can write cos of 45 also and sine of 45 also, right? So let's see, will it make any difference if it change? Will it make any difference if it will change? So suppose if I'm writing this as cos of 45 and this is sine of, this is sine of 45, this is cos of 45. So what I will do, first I will write as this as sine of 45 and this as cos of 45, right? So that means this will, this whole thing will become sine 45 degree into sine of x plus cos 45 degree into cos of x into root 2. This whole thing can be written as root 2 into, this whole thing can be written as root 2 into cos of x minus 45 degree. X minus 45 degree will become this, right? What is the range of cos of, so x minus 45 degree, x minus 45 degree, I can write as suppose a. So this will become root 2 into cos of a. This cos of a will be less than equals to 1 into root 2. So this will be less than root 2, greater than equals to minus root 2. Understood? This is when we are writing this as sine of. Suppose if I'm writing this as cos. Suppose if I'm writing this as cos. So this will be, I'll copy this once again. Just wait for a second. So I'll copy this part. Okay. So suppose instead of this sine 45, I'm writing this as cos of 45. And instead of this cos 45, I'm writing this as sine of 45. Okay. So then what will this become? So this is, this will become cos of 45 into sine of x plus sine of 45 into cos of x. Right. So that means this thing will become now into root 2, obviously into root 2. Yeah. So, root 2 I'm taking outside the bracket. Hai na? Root 2 I'm taking outside the bracket. Hai na? So what happens? Because root 2, when if I'm dividing with root 2, and so I will have to multiply with root 2 also, right? So this is root 2. So this will become, this whole thing will become sine of x plus 45 degree. Sine of x plus 45 degree. This x plus 45 degree, suppose if I'm writing as b. So sine x plus 45 degree root 2. So this is sine of b into root 2. Again, the range of this will become from plus root 2 to minus root 2. See, so no matter what you take, either this is cos x minus 45 or sine of x plus 45, both will give you exactly same range. Please remember, both will give you exactly same range. Range will not be, range will not be defined by whether it is cos inside or sine inside. I hope you understood. I hope everybody understood. Just copy this part. So taken sine theta, then it will become cos theta. Yes. So the only difference is here we are having sine of beta, here we are having cos of a, right? But the range is still same. Hai na? So now just copy this part, or you, if you want to copy, sir, by root 2. Bache, because root 2 will make, I told you, na, this is 1 into sine x, 1 into cos x. So that is why. That is why 1 square plus 1 square. 1 square plus root of 1 square plus 1 square is root 2. That is why I'm dividing here with root 2, root 2. In this case, 1 by root 2 is sine 45. 1 by root 2 is sine 45. So sine 45 and cos 45 will be same. So I will get it into a symbol, single trigonometric ratio. That is why I'm doing dividing with under root of a square plus b square. We can do with this 1 by 2. How can you can do this with 1 by 2? You cannot do this with 1 by 2, bacha. Because here, I will explain why you cannot do this with 1 by 2. The question was just simply find the range of sine x plus cos x. Sine x plus cos x. The question was simply find the range of sine x plus cos x, right? So now we have, the task is to combine into. So what I will do, I will divide with root 2 and I will multiply with root 2. So that is why. Just copy this one once. I hope this is okay for everyone. Are bache, sine x plus 45. I'm assuming x plus 45 is equals to b. Why is it so hard for you to understand that I'm substituting x plus 45 is equals to b? Why do you think that this is a miracle happening? Sir, why x plus 45 degree? Sine of x plus 45 is equals to sine of b. Sir, this is a magic. This is magic. It is not a magic. I've already told you this thing. I've assumed sine of x plus 45 as b. I've taken it as b. It is a variable. It is a name which I can take. It is a name which I can give. Are bacho, see. Yaar, bacho. Suppose your name is, right? If your name is suppose my name is Amit. Suppose my name is Amit. Okay. Suppose my name is Amit. And at home, suppose my mom calls me Sumit. And suppose at school, my friends call me Ramit. Okay. And suppose my dad has a special name. Dad calls me a special name suppose my dad calls okay. Bhumit. Fine. So even if you call these a different, if you will call me with a different name, does the person changes? The person still remains same. Right? So this X plus 45, I'm writing it as B. The person is still same. It is still X plus 45. I'm writing it as a different name. It does not make any difference. This is just an assumption that I'm taking. So don't ask me, sir, how X plus 45 becomes B. Hai na? Because it's not a, it is just that I'm assuming it so that I can easily write it. Hai na? So I can write it easily. Okay. Now see, let's take one more question. Find the range of 2 plus root 3 sine x plus cos x. Find the range of 2 plus root 3 sine x plus cos x. Vijay, bacha, I was also not able to hear because I do not have speaker. So what you can do, you can ask your friends. They have listened. So you can ask your friend. They will tell you, okay, what he has told. He was telling us about the Learnity and he was telling you to subscribe so that you can get all the videos and all the lectures in one place. Hai na? 0 to 4. Okay. Okay. 0 to 4. Very good, bacha. Very good. A new notebook for finding range type questions to write. Okay. So let's see this one also. Yes, 0 to 4. Many of you are saying 0 to 4. So see, this part is a constant. We do not have to worry about this part. This part is a constant. Hai na? This part is a constant. So we just have to worry about this because this will be the thing. This is a function in function of x. That means function of x and x is variable. X is a variable. So that means this thing will keep on changing. So we just have to take care of this part. So let's see. This is separate. Let's take this as separately. Now see. Root 3 sine x plus cos x into 1. This is root 3 sine x plus cos x into 1. So this I can divide and multiply with root 3 whole square plus 1 whole square into root 3 whole square plus 1 whole square. This will become root 3 sine x plus cos x into 2 divided by 2. So this will simply I can write as 2 into root 3 by 2 sine x plus 1 by 2 cos x. Right? Now this can be taken as cos theta. Hai na? So this will become 2 into cos, sorry, this will become 2 into sine theta plus x. This will become 2 into sine theta plus x. We know sine theta, sine of theta plus x can take maximum value of 1 and minimum value of minus 1. And if I multiply this 2, so this will become sine of theta plus x into 2. This will become 2 and greater than equals to minus 2. Right, so that this is the range of this part. So this part minimum value is minus 2 and maximum value is 2 for this part. If I will add 2 to this, so plus 2, 2 plus 2 sine of theta plus x, so 2 plus 2, and this will also be 2 minus 2. I will add 2 on all the sides, so this will become 0 and this will become 4. So the maximum value of this whole thing will be, so this whole thing will become maximum value will be 4. And the minimum value will be 0. Okay. Just copy this. Haan, bacha, don't worry. I will always send you PDF. Don't worry. I will send you the PDF every day. Don't worry about that. Hai na? Okay. Just copy this. Copy this, please. plus 2 equals to 4 and 2 my 2 minus 2 equals to 0. Last step. Okay, I will explain the last step, bache. Don't worry. I will explain the last step. Don't worry. First, you copy. I will give you 1 minute to copy. Then I will explain this part also. I will explain this part also. Hai na? I hope you have you have copied. So I will explain from this thing. 2 sine theta plus x. So 2 sine theta plus x. What this is. See. So what I can do is, we know sine of theta, I will write sine of theta plus x as sine of a, suppose. Hai na? Theta plus x I am writing as a. Hai na? Don't ask me, sir, how theta plus x becomes a. I am assuming it to be a. Okay. So I know sine of something is less than equals to 2, is less than equals to 1 and greater than equals to minus 1. Okay. Now I can multiply each side with 2. If I will multiply each side with 2, so this will become minus 2 greater than equals to 2. Sine of a less than equals to 2. So 2 sine theta will be less than equals to 2 and greater than equals to minus 2. This is okay. Hai na? Fine. Devdarshan, you can send me message. I will send you yesterday's PDF also. Hai na? I forgot. Hai na? So 2 sine a, this is okay. Now see, what is the question? So this thing whole, this part's range becomes from 0 to 2. Minus 2 to 2. This part's range becomes from minus 2 to 2. But there is 2 also added. 2 is also added. We have not taken 2 till now. So I will add 2 here. So I will add 2 here. So 2 minus 2 greater than equals to 2 plus 2 sine a less than equals to 2 plus 2. Right? So this will become 0. 2 plus 2 sine a and less than equals to 4. See, when I will substitute sine a value as when sine a is equals to minus 1. When sine a is equals to minus 1, this whole thing will become minus 2 plus 2, 0. So this is 0. And when sine a is taking maximum, that means 1. When sine a is 1, that means 2 plus 2, 4. That means this becomes 4. That means from 0 to 4 is the range of this whole thing. I hope you understood now. Devdarshan bache. This one is Raghavendra. Did you understood? Sri Raghavendra, did you understood now? Did you understood the concept now, Mr.? For quadratic, bacha, I'm not able to understand. For quadratic, which part? Quadratic is a little different, bacha. In quadratic, we are making a perfect square. In here, we are converting the sine or cos into a single sine or cos. Hai na? In quadratic, we were forming a perfect square. There is a method to find the range using the perfect square. That questions we will do tomorrow. But today I wanted to show you this method only. Hai na? So let's copy this one. I will stop here. The PDF file is not supporting. Why is it not supporting, bacha? PDF file. Okay. So I'm downloading the PDF file. I will share it with you now. Just wait for a second, bacho. First step, what I did is that I took, just wait. Okay, I will keep on. Yeah, so first part, what I did, that because this is root 3 sine x plus cos x. So because this root 3 is multiplied with sine x and 1 is multiplied with cos x. Right. So what I did, I divided and multiplied with root 3 square and 1 square. Okay. So now what happens? So this is root 3 plus 1 square. So this root 3 plus 1 square becomes 2. So 2 and 2 will get multiplied. So I got the range of this part. I got the range of this part, which is nothing but 2. But, hai na? But the thing is that I did not calculate the range of this, which I found, which I did not included this in this. So which I did afterwards in this step. From here, I have used the, hai na? So this is the same. Fine. Okay. I've shared the slides with you. I have shared the slides with you. Please look at this question once again. Write few question by yourself. You can multiply anything with sine x, multiply anything with cos x, real values, and you can find the range of all those individually. Okay. So I will stop the class now. Okay. I hope you are studying well, and please till tomorrow, till range of questions I will give. Till range of questions I will give. Okay. Fine. Chalo. Okay, I will teach the squaring method once again tomorrow. Okay, don't worry. I will teach the squaring methods once again tomorrow. Okay, chalo. Take care. Please study. Please solve all the questions and revise. Okay, chalo. Thank